Hey guys, I am Big and Scary. I'm bringing you game three of Team EchO's best of three tourney, featuring in our bottom left hand side, Bait, our blue Terran, and in our bottom right, we have EchO's Virus, our red Terran. Like I said, best of three, game three, ace match between the two Terrans. It's been a wild ride. I'm not gonna lie. It's been really, really fun because we've seen Virus do some shenanigans. He had a proxy in the first map, and it worked incredibly well for him. He used some Hellions to great effect, lifting off of barracks, doing some excellent damage. And then the second one kind of fizzled out with some pressure from some Reapers, not nearly as successful as it needed to be. And Bait just kind of took it and ran with it. He had a very small lead, and then it just grew and grew and grew, and he definitely dominated the mid game. So we're gonna see, is Virus gonna fall back on the things that worked? Pressure. Bait didn't do as well with pressure as Virus has done with pressure. I think Virus is a little bit superior in the micro mechanics, and I think Bait, if given half a second, is going to let his macro just run wild and will dominate Virus. So is that something that Virus can afford to do? I don't know. It's going to be a fantastic game. So game three, this is for the ace match. This is the last one of these two. Make sure you guys watch the other ones so that we can see when the next round comes out, probably next week, I believe. Here, Bait is throwing down his own proxy barracks. Excellent positioning. Is he going to pick it up and land it right here so that he can kind of proxy something into it? Or more likely, is it going to be Reapers so they can actually just jump up, a little hop jump down here and then a little hop jump up here? And all of a sudden, he's in the opponent's base with pretty much zero time lost. Virus's SCV is going to arrive to see an empty base with a gas. He's going to know that some shenanigans are up. I mean, check that out. 10 workers back at home, but 15 have been constructed. So I mean, he knows that this stuff is missing, especially the barracks. So he's going to know that there's some sort of proxy. He's going to be looking around for that. Based on what he was seeing, it is possible it could be a CC first build. It's not impossible to rule that out. But based on what we've seen in the last two games, I think that Virus is, his radar is going to be up. He's going to know that he needs to get his own barracks up in relatively short order. His own barracks is up. He's going to be working on those Marines in very quickly, I hope. He's not constructing anything just yet. There is a factory right on top of it, so probably going to be an add-on. Virus moving in with his SCV. Perfect. Absolute killer instincts moving in just to scout that barracks, seize the tech lab. In bygone days, this was going to be a Reaper harass, but now the only reason to get a tech lab is so that you can max out some Marauders, and this is not going to end well for him at all. That wall off is going to get completed in no time. Things were looking picture perfect. The barracks wasn't anywhere near the wall. He was going to be able to waltz right up there with whatever he wanted to construct, but now that the tech lab is done, the Marauder is going to be coming out, and he is researching Marauder slow, so this is still going to be a rather powerful push. But with the wall off completed, the Marine's going to be able to pop up inside that bunker. This is going to be very, very difficult for Bait to pull off. On the other side of thing, he does have map control. He could definitely continue, maybe construct an engineering bay right here and then just retreat. Lift out that barracks. You've lost pretty much nothing, and you are getting your CC down, and it's going to be a little while before EchO's Virus decides to push down here and try to reclaim the lower portion. So yeah, Virus has it contained right now. Relax with the contain. There's no reason to continue to pressure, and that's exactly what he's doing. He's got these really beefy Marines. Excellent play there by Bait, realizing that bunker was just barely within range, so that he can target it down with his Marines, popping them out of the bunker, even though if those Marines had gotten hit by those Marauders, it would be very difficult for them to make their way back into that bunker. A single Reaper is out on the field right now, and while we're at it, we should focus on what Virus is getting. He's got a reactor on the factory, going to be mass-producing two Hellions at a time, and a single starport. Is this going to be another round of Hellion drops for Virus? It definitely was very successful. Or is he just going to be using the hypermobility of those viruses, of those Hellions, to kind of prevent that Reaper from getting in there? Man, that Reaper was incredibly ballsy, only escaping with 4 health. Wow. Single medevac is on the way. No Hellions. Okay, there goes two extra Hellions. Fantastic. A factory is being constructed back at Bait's home, and the CC is almost done. So if he keeps this contained, if he doesn't sacrifice a lot of money, he's in fantastic shape still. Especially with the bunker on the low ground, this is going to be a pretty tough nut to crack when supported by two SCVs. But no, Bait really wants to make this work. He's pushing up. Those two Hellions are going to be able to target down those Marauders. One SCV goes down pretty much instantly. And yeah, the Bunker's taking some hull damage, but with four SCVs pulled, all that's going to do is draw the aggro from those Hellions, allowing the Reapers to slip in. But with three Hellions, four Hellions on the field right now, one of the Reapers doesn't escape with his life, and the other one, taking significant damage, is going to have to take a couple seconds to heal back up. On the other side of things, Bait, back at home, he's working on that tech. This is exactly what he needs to do. Like I said, he's a macro player. He does so well with that macro, and we saw that he can out-macro Virus if left to his own devices. Once again, canceling. He canceled that first Bunker. He's canceling quite a lot. He's actually losing a lot of money because of that, those canceling. But ultimately, he canceled that starport. He wants to invest in the ground, so that's just fine. Moving in with those two Reapers, where are those Hellions? Well, they're in a medevac, and that medevac is right on the outside of Bait's home base, and those Reapers, you know, that was pretty successful. Actually moved in, killed two SCVs, actually only one probably, before overstaying his welcome and leaving, which is weird to see him pull back. I think the reason he pulled back was because those Hellions weren't anywhere. He's nervous about what's going on back at home. And what's going on back at home? Bunch of Hellions being dropped, and they're already in battle mode. Absolutely fantastic. Instantly melting away. We saw only one worker was killed just a short time ago, but now Virus has killed five, and all he needs to do is engage these SCVs for a very short period of time. Nice split coming up from Bait, keeping them alive. Oh, but Virus, looking like he was going to retreat, instead drops the battle Hellions, and remember that medevac can heal up those battle Hellions because they are biological units right now in this form. And four battle Hellions can just melt away that siege tank, even though it was being repaired by that plethora of SCVs. One Hellion does go down, and there is a little bit of anti-air on the field right now. The Reapers have retreated to add a little bit of support back at home. However, the Hellions are just being so incredibly cost-effective. 18 workers killed, 11 over 22 right now. Virus is in a commanding lead, having done a ridiculous amount of damage. Would be much better served to have spent those Reapers into the mineral line of Virus while he's doing this aggression and just let them rack up some kills while Virus obviously has his attention focused elsewhere. On the other side of things, that orbital command is completed. Bait could afford to reposition it. He can max out on the SCVs. He can bounce back from this. He is starved for money, though. Only 8 harvesters, but with 2 mules at a time. His mineral income is actually not bad at all. Mass produce those Marines. Hope that he doesn't lose a bunch of them to the Hellions. There's no reason Bait can't come back from this. That being said, Virus is got to be feeling really good about himself. So he's got that... He's done a massive amount of damage. He can definitely afford to rack up a couple more Hellions back at home, maybe a couple of Marauders himself, and push out and take his own natural. Or he could just continue to pressure Bait back at home and win this game outright. One of the battle Hellions just now morphing into battle mode, I guess. And with half of them going down, it looks like only 4 of the battle Hellions remain. But with 3 medevacs healing them all up, those battle Hellions are going to be almost impossible to take down with what Bait can create. Unfortunately, there's no siege tanks being produced. Siege tanks would have done wonders against these Hellions. But really, I mean, Bait is just on the back foot, and there's really not much he can do to pull himself back into this game. Virus, now that he's gotten a commanding control of what exactly is on the ground, he morphs into Hellion mode so he can chase down those SCVs, and they all just get absolutely melted away. Poor Bait, he's going to have to tap out for this one. This is game 3, so he is knocked out of the tourney. Virus moving on to the next round, which is also going to be a best of 3. He's going to meet up with Clockwork, our Zerg friend, and maybe we're going to see more than just a mirror match there. This was a good game, too. I mean, but Bait, he definitely tried something different. I don't really recognize a proxy Marauder push. You see that sometime in Protoss versus Terran, because that is rather effective, especially with slowing down the Zealots so they can't really get in the range, and then you prevent the Stalkers from microwaving away. But unless that front door is down, if you saw, 2 Marines versus 2 Marauders, you should lose. But you got that bunker up on the high ground. There's not much those Marauders can do. So really good play there by Virus, scouting out that proxy was indeed happening, realizing that he was missing key structures back at home, and then realizing that he had secured his front door. He doesn't really have to feel too pressured about those Reapers that were poking in from the side. Oh, nice. A Widow Mine. I totally missed that. Unfortunately, he didn't get a kill. So that's okay, actually. Realizing that he had pretty much locked down his home and that he needed to push out and do a little bit of economic damage to prevent Bait from getting away with the economic advantage that he had earned. It was a good game, though. It was a very good game. And that's it, guys. Bait, unfortunately, knocked out. Virus moving on to the next one. I will see you guys later. I am Big and Scary.